quick dialogue, and if it gets to where it's super, super swimmy, whoever's getting swimmy for, I want you to stop me, and I'll say it again, trying to make it as clear as I can. There's a lot of numbers that I use in this class, right? We all use a lot of numbers, okay? I think sometimes it gets weird, okay? So I want to say one thing. If I say 5 or 7, or 7 diminished, more than likely, I'm talking about the numeral, which means the chord. 5, 7, 1, 2, 3, if I say those things, okay? If I say root, third, fifth, seventh, I'm talking about chord factors. Okay? And if I say insert number, second, and I add scale degree, I'm talking about the individual note within the key. Okay? So there's a lot of different stuff that's, and I'm still throwing a number out there, but it means different stuff. Okay? And I think sometimes that gets confusing when we're charting all this madness up here and then we're going into it and trying to make stuff happen. So, when I say on the 5 in minor, what I mean is that. Does that make sense? Because I said 5, so I'm referring to the chord. Okay? Now, if I say on the 5, you raise the 7th scale degree. When I say that, I say on this chord, you raise the 7th scale degree, which refers back to the key. So in the key of E, I have E or E minor, excuse me, E, F sharp, G, I can't write for anything. G, A, B, C, D, E, F sharp. Crap. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. D sharp. Yay. I cannot spell at all right now. So I can use numbers all day long, but I have to use letters, and there I go, right? Okay. So what I mean when I say 7th scale degree, raising it a half step, is that. Now, who all have I completely freaked out and no one knows what's going on? We okay-ish here? About to add the third level. Okay. So, once I have this, I have raised the 7th scale degree of the key. But that 7th scale degree, guys, is the 3rd chord factor. Does that make sense? So I didn't raise the 7th of the chord, because that would have changed that, right? I raised the 7th of the key, which always refers back to this guy. Remember how I told you need a key for any of this junk to make sense? That's part of the reason why. Okay, because without that, what the hell are we doing here? I don't know. You know, like, there's just too many numbers. Okay? So I always tie this back. 5 refers back to the key as well, but when I say 5, I mean the chord, 5. When I say 5th scale degree, I mean the letter pitch. So if I say 5th scale degree in this key, that's B. If I say the 5 in this key, that's B major, because it's an entire chord. Does that somewhat make sense? Okay? And then once I'm inside the chord, then I can say root, third, fifth, because now I'm dealing with chord factors. There's a different level of interaction that's happening now. Okay, so I think about like those click to zoom, right? You click zoom in there, you get a little bit. And then you click again, you're a little bit tighter, right? That's essentially what we're doing here, okay? But we use the same repetitive numbers because 1 through 7 happens all the time in music, right? So then I have to be able to intelligently have this conversation about what number means what, depending on the context, okay? So, let's go through here. The first thing when you're dealing with this, guys, and remember, this is something that you really have to sort out this to all work out the right way. If you can't answer this question, you need to be able to answer that question. Okay? is an implied question, because what it implies is that I know to add these four sharps when given this context, right? If I don't know that, none of the rest of the stuff's going to be right, because everything is predicated on that existing. Okay? So now, once I do that, okay, now E. Here's the one chord. And then remember, I just let the key, for major keys, I just let the key signature take over, because it does everything how I need it to do it. Okay? So E, G sharp, and B is a major triad. I don't have to do anything. Okay? And then when I add D sharp, all I'm going to do is just observe that it was a 7 added onto it, and that's enough to tell me that it is what it is. Keys are friendly like that. Once you get to know them, they're quite friendly. Okay? Now, I come over here and I say F sharp, A, C sharp. Now, again, this is a minor triad. A lot of times what happens is we see a bunch of sharps and we think, well, that couldn't possibly be minor, so we start throwing flats at everything. Well, all we did is just change the key and make it work not very well. Okay? So let the key do its job, because this is a minor triad. And then when I add the 7th again, I'm going to say, oh, look, there was a 7th on top of that. Cool. Observe and report. That's all you're doing. Okay? And then you come over here, G sharp, B, that's a minor 3rd. G sharp to D sharp is the 1st 5th. So this is a minor triad. And when I observe the 7th on top of it, I'm done. Think of yourself like those UN peacekeepers, right? They go in there and they're like, I'm going to go look at this civil war and just tell people what's happening. Right? You're just going to go in there and look at it and say, oh, that's what's happening. You're not really there to change it. Okay? That's not the job when you're dealing with major keys. Alright? So, I come through, I'm using the key signature. Guess what I'm going to do? I'm not going to add a single accidental the whole time. It's just going to all be perfect. And if life were like a major key, everyone would be happy. Actually, I have my doubts. I think we'd all find a way to be unhappy, but that's okay. Okay, so then we come over here. Now, here's the deal with the minors, though. With the minors, and this is where we get into this a little bit. I think about this like, we look at the minor keys and we say, why can't you be more like your brother? You know? It's like, some things. But then I just really wish that I could have this and this. Why do you have to make it so hard? Right? So what we have to do is we have to go in here, we have to make a couple of tweaks. Okay? But here's what's beautiful about minor keys. It's always the same tweak, and it's always on the same two chords. Okay, so if you remember the pattern, it's not that hard, because it doesn't change. Okay? So what I'm going to do is, everything that is not 5 and 7, I do the same thing as before. I observe and report, but I have to remember the key signature, or it doesn't work out. Okay, so that's that. A lot of times people panic. They see this diminished symbol, and they think, whoa, got to change something. Nope. This is a naturally occurring diminished triad. The 7th is a naturally occurring minor 7. This is what it is. I don't have to do it. Okay? It's not 5 and 7, no tweaking. There's that. Everything is doing. And then I roll up into 5, and all of a sudden, it's all not exactly perfect. Okay? So I look at this and I say, okay, what did it ask me for? A major triad with a minor 7th on. Okay? So I've got a minor triad with a minor 7th on, and that's not what I wanted. Okay? So I go, it's 5, it's major. How am I going to make it major? I'm going to raise the 7th scale degree. And remember, the 7th scale degree always comes back to this. Right? Comes back to the key that you were in. So that, in this case, is D, which becomes D sharp. So I make that one tweak, and that's it. And that changes everything. That makes this a major 3rd, perfect 5th, minor 7th. It's the 5-7 that I always knew I wanted. Right? And it's just one change. I didn't have to do more. And you never will have to do more. You'll never have to change two notes, just one. Okay? Come over to the sixth, same thing. I say, yay, observe and report. Seven diminished, seven. And here comes the other thing. Okay, so I've got, okay, this is a dominant seven. Well, crap, because dominant seven is supposed to happen on Fox. So that's not what I needed, okay? So same thing, I raise the seventh scale degree, so I come back here and I say, E minor, seventh scale degree. Make it so. And now what I have is I have a minor third, a diminished fifth, and a diminished seventh. So this is that fully diminished seventh. There's no slash anymore. It's just a circle. Okay? Now, here's the thing that also makes people panic. That's a fully diminished, you cannot get a tighter seventh chord than that. And what do I have? I have one sharp showing up. There's no flats, right? And a lot of times people get the sense that there has to be a flat, right? It couldn't possibly. You can have chords that are fully diminished that only have sharps in them. That is very much possible, okay? So don't get the sense that if it doesn't have a flat, it has to be wrong. That's not true, okay? Don't make any more than one change. How many changes do you see here? One change, one change. I want you guys to see. This is chaos is what this is. So I'm going to get rid of all this junk. Now, cast your mind back however many years of months ago it was that we were talking about parallel majors and minors. This is the parallel major and this is the parallel minor, right? They both start on E. Okay? So, none of the other chords matched up, but the five will. So if you see, this is the exact same chord as that. Does it look like the exact same chord? Not exactly. But if I go into all the components, it is. It's a B, that's a B. It's a D sharp, that's a D sharp, because F sharp, that's an F sharp, that's an A, that's an A. So it's the exact same chord. So in all the keys, whatever the parallel is, C major, C minor, D minor, E flat major, E flat minor, you're going to have the exact same 5 chord. And you're going to have the exact same 5-7 chord. Okay? One's going to require that accidental change to do it. But you're always going to end up with the exact same chord. Okay? So, E flat major. 5-7 is B flat, D, F, A flat. B flat minor, with all this cuckoo-ville happening, right? All those flats, it's going to be the exact same notes. But I have to come back to my seventh scale degree and raise that half step. So now I have B flat, D, D, F, F, A flat, A flat. It's the exact same chord. Okay? So they have the same 5-7, and they have the same time. That's kind of one of the cool things about it, okay? But remember, as many flats were in this key, how many naturals did I add? Just the one, right? It's only ever one change to the seventh scale degree that makes the chord happen, okay? And if I wanted the seven diminished seven, D natural, F, A flat, so good? Okay. So keep working at this. If you're struggling with key signatures, do your review on your key signatures, because we're not far out from this whole semester being a wrap. You have to show me all the stuff that we've done, right? So work on those. We're going to come back and talk on Wednesday more about the inversions of the seventh chords. Okay? We're going to do that with